Yes, welcome again my dear friends. Let's see how to create a JSP page. To create a JSP page, first of all we need a web application. Okay, to create a web application, create new web project. For that, just right click on Project Explorer, select new project. From the categories, select Java web and select web application from the project category. After selecting a web application, click on the next button. In next window, provide the project name. Let me give my web app. Okay, you can change project location by clicking on browse button. Now click on the next button. As soon as you click on the next button, it will ask for the server. I have installed both GlassFish server and Apache, but I will prefer Apache server. Select appropriate Java version. I will choose Java 7. Don't change the context path. Then click on the next button. Now it will ask for the framework we are going to use in our web application. Currently I am not going to use any framework, so I am not going to select it. Just click on the finish button. Now you can see some structure of files get created over here. So, and one index.html file get created. Okay, so currently we are focusing on the JSP page. So let's create one simple JSP page. Just right click on the web pages, select the new option. As you can see, JSP is already listed over there. If in your NetBeans JSP is not there, then click on the other. Then in filter, type JSP. Okay, it will display JSP page selected. Then click on the next. As you can see, it will ask for the file name. I will give it index. Then click on the finish. As you can see, index.jsp file get created. Okay, to run it, just right click, run file. Or as you know, the shortcut, that is Shift F6. First time it will require some time to execute. This file display title JSP page and display text in H1 style, that is hello world. Let's see. Yes, it's working. Here is the title of the page, JSP page, and displaying hello world. Okay, you can change the world. Sorry, hello from JSP. Save it and run it again, or you can just refresh it over here. Hello from the JSP. So that's it.